Well, thank you, Carlos and Michuki and Shane, for having me here. It's my pleasure, my honor, and a big surprise and a big responsibility to be here. I'm completely overwhelmed for what you have been doing here during all this time, and the amount of heart put on what you do. So congratulations to you all. You really deserve to be put on the first page of whatever of a very newspaper that are wrong. So if it's not happening, they are really not getting it. I'm going to split my talk in two parts. The first part is not about directly related to community networks, but about what we are doing here and where you come from and what you do, what you were doing before community networks and why you're doing community networks. And it's about sharing a little bit about our vision from Alter Mundi of the world we are building. So I will read it because I don't remember it, but please keep that here. So Alter Mundi sees itself as the technological leg of the alternative world that is possible. We think that the path of concentration and control that humanity is following has no future, not only because of the injustice of the global distribution of wealth, but also because the environmental consequences of the path that we are following is not compatible with life on Earth. We have to decide whether we are simply going to be part of the history of the Earth, or if we are going to change course. We believe that this change of course is both possible and necessary, and every day we choose whether or not to make it happen. If we see the concentration and control of power, capital, or knowledge, and we don't resist or generate alternatives, then we are passively or actively accepting whatever the owners of power decide for us. When the megacorporations represent the model of egoism and private interest over the interest of the collective and over the interest of Mother Earth, every day many groups of people, like you and I, around the world are creating alternatives grounded in collaboration and a social and environmental consciousness. Free and open source software, community media, farmer movements, food sovereignty, cooperative production, fair trade groups, community networks, guardian of ancestral knowledge, alternative currency models, and the list just keeps on and on. These are just a few manifestations of alternatives to this dominant model I was talking about. Alter Mundi's work on community network is grounded in our belief in the alternative world that is possible. We believe that self-provision of telecommunication services, so together with the work of community media, support empowerment and self-determination. We believe that freeing portions of internet will help us connect and organize each other. In communities where we have forgotten that we can work together, community networks are the perfect excuse to get together and start recreating and reinforcing the bonds that allows us to face the other challenges together. The community network itself only has value when it allows us to strengthen the protection of our territories and our ability to transform ourselves and each other. So this is kind of a manifesto, or it's the very, very short version of a very big manifesto of what we strive for. But we believe, we have been talking about all this technology there are images of the communities that we have been working with, Aldermundi is not itself by itself a community network. We are an organization that promotes community network around the world, specifically in Latin America, but we hope to be helping and supporting more communities worldwide in the near future. And what I have been telling you is about the reality of our communities. Whenever there is no internet, we believe that that's not the only thing that is our communities are required. Where there is no internet, there is usually no water, there is usually no food, no proper housing, no education. There is usually people that is getting a lot from our people, like using their power to struggle to using the power that we give them to put them in a better position than the rest of the community. So what we try to do is to build technology that allows people to relate in a peer-to-peer way, instead of like someone that provides to the ones that can't provide for themselves. And I'm not saying that we don't have to speak to the other world, like the rest of the world. What I'm saying is that we as social movements, as we as all, have to recognize our nature, recognize where we come from, who do we serve, where do we belong, and to build the technologies and the reality from our standpoint. I mean, the power, let me go a little bit further. The power begins there, okay? There, the individual, one of our members of one of our communities, has all the power it needs to provide himself with everything that it is in his life. But the system has made it so that takes the power out of that person and ask them for something in return, to give it away again, okay? So if we harness the power that we have in ourselves and we work together to build the things that we need, then these situations will be no longer a reality in our communities. And community networks are one excuse, as I said, to get together and find out that we can get something done together. In Quintana, one of our communities, we began the network because we had someone that was like a promoter. Everything begins with the will of one person. Okay, that person gathered a small group of friends that wanted to push this forward, and with that person, with that group of people, they gathered together and started the network. Once they showed that the network was possible, the rest of the town just joined them because it was logical. Why would I pay a provider to give me service if I can't do it for myself? What the first ones gave to the others was the realization that they were able to give something for themselves. But that something that they weren't aware of before that happened. So it's basically what you're doing for your communities. You are showing that it is possible for someone, for an everyday person that was born there and lived there, to give themselves connectivity and to show them that they can also do that for themselves. Well, Carlos, I will jump to the other part of the talk, and it will be, I encourage you to, I don't know if it's okay, but if I miss something or you want to know a little bit more about something that I'm not mentioning, please stop me and ask, okay? So Carlos asked me to speak about the specifics of our networks. So one of the majority of our networks are community driven, community built, and community expanded. So So it's a little bit different about the, than your reality, many of the reality of your communities, of your networks. And it's because perhaps our society is different. I mean, we have many other things solved and we can sit together and talk about these things instead of talking about how, why we don't have education or why we. So there are other things that are already solved, so we can talk about this. The way we organize economically, or we propose our networks to organize economically, is through cooperation. We invite the communities to decide whether they are able to put some money, monthly money, but not to pay for a service, for an outside service, but to have a fund to be used on the community needs. Okay, there in our group we have this fund we use for connectivity, so to buy bandwidth to connect to other networks, and to replace equipment that gets burned by lightning, for example, because we are using cheap hardware. It makes no sense to protect the routers, the lightning. If a lightning strikes one, it's cheaper to replace it than to protect it. So we have this fund that we use to replace the devices, and it's a very easy funding, because the amount of money that they put every month is up to them. It's not up to us. I mean, we don't say them how much they have to pay. They decided as a collaboratively. How we get the bandwidth is a thing that is interesting, because in many communities we have got to agreements with public institutions. For example, in the region of Cordoba, we have an agreement with the local university, and the local university provides us with their spare bandwidth and local housing for our servers, and also peering with the network the university has peering with. So we have access to CDN, the global CDNs of Google and Facebook and all those big ones, without paying anything. And if we need to get to the global internet, we use the bandwidth that the university provides to us. Before that, before having that agreement, we had an agreement with a wholesale internet provider that he saw. I don't know. We kind of get along from the beginning, and they basically gifted us with a lot of bandwidth. But because they could, I mean, they are like, I don't know, tier 3, that's called, like the nationwide provider, tier 1? Okay, they are like a tier 1 provider, the ones that provide connectivity to the countries or the cities, okay? So they didn't matter if they would sell, so one line of 100 megabits more or less, so they just give it to us freely. Okay, so that's about, yeah.
You guys probably already noticed the Oz internet. It should be back in 50 minutes, actually more than close to 10. The good news is nobody goes back.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, thank you.
There is no internet within 50 minutes.
Okay. Great to know. Okay, then another thing that we try to promote strongly is to have local meaning. Like, the network has to have meaning in itself. It's not a way to access the network, the internet, but it's a way to get connected to each other, and through that connectivity to create the reality that we need to create. Like, the networks that we build support the social structure that is already there. So if I have to talk to my neighbor, the network has to provide us the means to do that. Okay? But in the best way possible. So if we can put a local server to get in touch without using mainstream voice over IP services, then great. If we have a peer-to-peer technology that we can use in order not to require a server there, better, because we don't need a technician in our community to maintain a server if it's not needed. So in our communities, we usually deploy a server that hosts a captive portal that is used to contain local information, usually classifieds that the community, like I have something to sell, so I put it there, or if there is a job opening, then I can publish it there. Or whether there is something that the community needs to be aware of. For example, last year there was a mining enterprise that tried to be hosted close to one of the towns, and it was kind of secrecy. So they tried to put a mine in our community without telling us, and they paid all the people that had to be paid, so anything gets out before the mining started. But someone told us that this was happening, and through the social structure that was created because of the community network, we got to get to the environmental public institution of the region. We took there 200 people, that is historically the most the most amount of people that were in a public audience ever in the history of that organization, of that environmental public institution. So what we get through the social constructs that we can provide to our community, like community networks, is not only giving connectivity, but also giving the understanding that together they can get things done, that together they can find common goals and make them reality much easier than doing it by themselves. So, you were talking also about sustainability. So there are many things about sustainability to be talked about. For example, the technical sustainability, right? I talked about the replacement of the hardware and what we do. What we also do is we have these workshops that we give once. We have like a dynamic that is called a workshop. It's a two-day meetup where we teach what we know, but it's not Altamundi the one that teaches it, but the people from the community that teach each other the knowledge. And when a community close nearby wants to join or wants to create a community network, they can reach another community that is already deployed and ask them for teaching, for a workshop. So that that helps us ensure that the knowledge is always there and it's always, everyone knows about how to deploy a community network. So that's another thing. The knowledge is not reserved. The way we promote community networks is that everyone knows how to deploy it. Not the technicians, not the youngers, not the males, everyone. Like families, have you seen the images? Entire families are doing their antennas and are building their nodes, are putting the antennas in the ceilings. So everyone is welcomed and is encouraged to join the network.